Hi, welcome to RS Agarwal official channel. My name is Rashi and today I am going to teach you science. So we are going to start with first chapter of science, which is chemical reaction and equation. So in today's lecture, we are going to discuss what is a chemical reaction. When you are telling anybody that a chemical reaction is taking place, what does it mean? So we are going to discuss in this chapter the meaning of a chemical reaction. So let's start. Okay, students. So in first image, you can see that on one side we have milk and on other side we have curd. If you left your milk in summers out for some time, you'll see that it will give an unpleasant, souring smell. Why that is taking place? Because curdling, you can say that curdling or souring of milk is taking place. In this process, what is happening? A chemical reaction is taking place inside your milk. Your milk contains a sugar which is lactose. Okay, student. So during this reaction, your lactose sugar, which is present in your milk, is getting converted into lactic acid. Okay, so that means when a chemical reaction is taking place, the properties of new substance are completely different from the old substance. Now let's take another example. When we have a new iron chain, it will seem very shiny, very lustrous to you, but after some days you will observe that there is accumulation of a brownish substance on that iron chain. So this is also a chemical reaction in which your iron is getting reacted with air and water molecules to form this brownish compound, which is known as rust. So this process is known as rusting of iron. Okay, so now let's see what is a chemical reaction. Chemical reaction is a process. Okay, student, it is a process through which new chemical compounds, new chemical substances having new properties are formed. Previously, we have seen that in the example, when we have taken the example of milk and curd, the properties of milk are completely different from the properties of curd. So that means a new chemical compound is being formed from the previous one, and both of them have completely different chemical properties. Now, every chemical change is a result of a chemical reaction. Whenever you say that a chemical reaction is taking place, it means that some kind of chemical change has been taking place. Chemical change is conversion of one set of chemical substances into other. What does the statement mean is that if you will take one set of chemical compounds which have different properties and you react them with different chemical compound, they will react to form completely different chemical compounds. So this is a chemical change, a chemical reaction. Chemical change is irreversible. Once your milk is getting converted to curd, you cannot get back milk from the curd. So it means that chemical change is a permanent change. It cannot be reversed. Now let's discuss some examples of chemical reaction in our day-to-day life. So first example we are going to discuss is cellular respiration. Students, when we are respiring, what we are doing? We are inhaling oxygen from the atmosphere and we are exhaling carbon dioxide. So in this process, what we are doing, our body is converted a molecule of oxygen into a molecule of carbon dioxide. So basically we can say that it is a chemical reaction. Why? Because our body is converting one kind of chemical substance into other kind of chemical substance. The properties of oxygen and the properties of carbon dioxide are entirely different. So our body is converting one molecule of oxygen to the molecule of carbon dioxide. So it is a chemical change which is taking place inside our body. A chemical reaction is taking place. Now let's discuss other example, burning of fuel. Okay, when we say a fuel is being burnt, what does that mean? Fuel, or you can say any kind of fuel, if I have taken CH4, which is methane. Okay, methane will react with oxygen to form carbon dioxide and water, and a lot of heat energy. Obviously, when we burn a fuel, a lot of heat energy will be released. Okay, so in this example, what we can see that different kind of chemical compounds, which are methane and oxygen, are reacting to form some different chemical compounds, which are carbon dioxide and water, and also liberating a lot of amount of heat to the atmosphere. Okay, so this is also a chemical process in which we are converting, we are making different chemical compounds. Now let's see the other example, which is digestion of food. When we eat food, why we are eating food? Because we require some kind of energy. We need to perform our metabolic processes. For those metabolic processes, we need energy. So that energy we get from our food. So how we are getting that energy from our food is by a chemical reaction which is taking place. So in this chemical reaction, what is happening? Sugar molecule, or you can say the protein, vitamins, carbohydrates, whatever you are consuming, are getting converted into smaller molecule, are decomposing into smaller molecules, and also liberating energy in the form of ATP. ATP is, it is a chemical compound whose complete name is, you can say, adenosine triphosphate. Okay, this is a chemical compound which provides energy to our cells, to our tissues, to our body, to perform our daily jobs. Okay, so this is also a chemical reaction, because sugar is reacting with oxygen to form ATP molecules to provide energy to our body. Now, when we are saying, till now we have seen various examples of chemical reaction, but you can have this thing in mind, how do we know that a reaction is a chemical reaction? How you are saying that digestion of food is a chemical reaction, or respiration is a chemical reaction? How we are deciding that a given reaction is a chemical reaction? So students, this can be done by seeing some characteristics of a chemical reaction, or you can say some properties of a chemical reaction. Okay, these are the properties or characteristics. By seeing or by going through these properties, we can judge that a given reaction is a chemical reaction or not. So in this, first we have change in the state, and second one is change in color, then we have evolution of a gas, and then we have change in temperature. So now we are going to discuss one by one all of these. Let's come to first characteristic, which is change in state. So change in state means that a solid is getting converted to liquid, or a liquid is getting converted to gaseous state. The states are changing. We have three primary states: solid, liquid and gaseous. So these are getting interconverted. So if we'll see this example, in this example we have taken us two solutions. One is potassium iodide, and another, second one, is lead nitrate. So from this image you can see that both the solutions are liquids, right? So when these two reactions are reacting, chemically reacting, what is forming is lead iodide and potassium nitrate. So here the lead nitrate is coming in solid state. So when we mix solution of lead iodide, solution of potassium iodide with lead nitrate solution, what we are getting? A yellow precipitate. Any solid obtained by a chemical reaction is known as a precipitate. So we are getting a precipitate, a yellow colored precipitate of lead iodide. Okay, so in this reaction we can see that there is some kind of changes taking place, some kind of chemical changes taking place. Why we are saying this? Because change in state is happening. Now let's come to second characteristic. Second one is change in color. Okay, in this example we are taking a fresh shiny lustrous iron nail and dipping it in a blue color solution of copper sulfate. Okay, this is the before image. When you dip it in a blue solution, after some time what is happening? The color of the solution is changing from blue to green and there is an accumulation of a brownish substance on the iron nail. Now what's happening in this reaction is that your iron, okay, you have iron nail and you are dipping it in copper sulfate solution. So what is happening here? Iron is reacting with copper sulfate solution to form iron sulfate and copper. Okay, so copper sulfate solution is blue in color, but your iron sulfate solution is green in color. Okay, that is why your color is changing from blue to green. Okay, now next characteristic is evolution of a gas. If a gas is being evolved, we'll say that a chemical reaction is taking place. So in this example, what we have done, we have taken dilute sulfuric acid, which is liquid. Okay, this is liquid. And we are adding some zinc granules in the sulfuric acid solution. And then we are putting a cork on top of it. Okay, so as soon as we do this, we'll observe that some kind of bubbling is happening inside our solution, our sulfuric acid solution. Okay, some bubbles are being formed. So what is happening inside? Some gas is getting evolved. That is why this bubbling can be seen. So if you want to check it, that what gas is being evolved, if you take a burning matchstick, if suppose this is a matchstick, you'll take a burning matchstick near the nozzle, you will hear some popping sound. Okay, so that popping sound is given by evolution of hydrogen gas. So what chemical reaction is taking place? Your zinc, which is Zn, is reacting with sulfuric acid solution to give you zinc sulfate and H2 gas. And when your H2 gas is being evolved, okay, it's getting evolved, it is coming out of the solution, then this bubbling of the gas can be seen in the conical flask. Now let's come to other property with characteristic, which is change in temperature. So suppose we have taken sodium hydroxide pellets and we dissolved it in water. Then what happened after, if you measure suppose initial temperature of your system, let's take it come around 25 degrees Celsius, okay? And once you dissolve your sodium hydroxide in water, after some time you'll see that your beaker is getting hotter. Okay, it's get heat up, and the temperature, if you will measure it, let's take final temperature, you'll see it will coming around something 40 or something, like your initial temperature and your final temperature will be greater than initial temperature. Why? Because when you dissolve sodium hydroxide in water, it is evolving out heat, it is giving out heat, or what these kind of reaction we use a term, that is exothermic reaction. Okay, Exothermic reactions are those reactions which evolved heat, which give out heat to the surroundings. Okay, so when we'll touch the beaker, we'll see that it is getting heat up. Why this is happening? Because a chemical reaction is taking place which is bringing out this change in temperature. Okay, so these all are our characteristics features. So what we have done till now is we have seen what a chemical reaction is and what are various examples of chemical reactions, and also we have seen that how we'll decide a reaction is chemical reaction or not by judging them based on characteristics of a chemical reaction. Okay students, so this is it for today. In our next lecture, we'll further discuss what is a chemical equation, how to balance it. Okay, so thank you very much, and this is it for today's video.